In the last video, we gave a relatively naive view of what a processor is and how the memory interacts with the processor. We then used this to justify that when you do a matrix-matrix multiply, you can partition the matrix and bring blocks of the matrix into cache and get reuse out of it to overcome the memory bottleneck. This is actually a good moment to take a pause for a second and look at some of the architectural features that you have seen behind me in these videos. Okay. What we have here is what used to be called a core memory. Core memory consisted of a bunch of wires and little rings, and those rings could be magnetized positive or negative. Now, my estimate is that there's probably about 1,024 bits that can be stored here. Maybe it's more, maybe it's less. I'm not sure. I haven't counted it recently. The important thing is back then, one had very little memory, and therefore data had to be chunked into smaller chunks that could fit in core memory. The data was actually stored on magnetic tapes back then. And then one brought in the data, would do a bunch of computation, and eventually write it back out. Now notice that the principle behind that was very similar to what we just discussed about cache memories. Okay? We no longer store the data on tape. Instead, we have it in main memory. We no longer have core memory. We have cache memory. But the principle is the same. Main memory is very slow compared to cache memory. Just like back then, tape was very slow compared to core memory. Anyway, let me put this back and then let's get to our lesson.